guys, this is DemiTube on SharpWriter. Today I'm going to be showing you how I made this Team Skull Admin Plumeria doll from Pokemon Sun and Moon. So I'm going to be using two dolls that I got at the thrift store. One is a Bratz doll and the other is a Barbie. I'm not exactly sure about either of these, so not exactly sure about the character of either of these. I just found them at the thrift store and they weren't in great condition, so that's why I'm using them. They have very similar skin tones, so I'm going to be putting the Bratz head on the Barbie body because I really like her articulation, and she's taller than the Bratz, so yeah. I'm not going to be showing the process on camera because it requires a lot of tools and elbow grease, and I'm probably going to make a huge mess on this table if I do it, so I'm just going to do this elsewhere. Alright, so this is how it looks now, and honestly it looks kind of nice, and just for fun, I decided to put the Barbie head on the Bratz body. It looks really weird, so I'm just gonna put that away and move on to the next step. So to make Plumeria's little skull thingies on her head, I'm gonna be using some clay, so I'm just gonna take a little bit and shape them into her skull head thingies. Just cleaned off my hands, and these guys are still a bit squishy. I have some really long wefts right here that I made out of yarn, and yeah, I wasn't lazy this time, mostly because I don't have any more options to be lazy. So here are the yellow ones, and here are the pink ones, and I'm just gonna sort of stab them in here. I'm not gonna keep them in here, I'm just gonna make some holes so that I know where they go after these dry. I'm just going to go ahead and remove the factory paint using some pure acetone. I think that's as far as we're getting. So this is literally my first time trying to film a face-up, so it's probably not gonna be too great. Thank you. as far as I got with the watercolor pencils, and now I'm going to touch it up with acrylics, and it's really hard for me to see with the computer, the camera in front of me, so I'm going to be doing that part off camera. Alright, so this is how she looks now. It's not the best, but I tried. And I think if I try any harder, I'm going to screw it up. So I'm just going to stop here and move on. So, wow, my hand's a mess. These things that I made earlier are dry now, so I'm going to be painting them. And I didn't really bother washing my hands because they're going to get even messier while I paint these guys. Hardware clothes, I'm going to be using this crop top thingy that I got. This is also from a thrift store, and I'm just going to attach the straps on the bottom to make it look like an X. So I'm just going to paint this black. So I did the hair on her head off camera because it was really chaotic and I had no idea what I was doing. Some of her original hair is kind of showing, but I don't really mind because I don't think pink is her natural hair color. So yeah, and now I'm just gonna glue these on her head like this. So I'm heating up my glue gun right now and I'm just gonna glue that on her. I think that's pretty good. Let's move on to our clothes. Okay, so I let this dry, and because of the little sparkly things that were on the original one, they're still kind of showing through the paint, but I honestly don't mind. I'm just going to glue these strips of fabric on the bottom so I can make the X on the front and put that on her. And I'm going to also glue this white strip around her waist so it can be a waistband. So let's just do that. Too bad. So now I'm just gonna do the zigzag pattern on her legs using this. sketch out a really tiny Team Skull logo on this tiny piece of cardstock and get her necklace. This is pretty ridiculous. And I think I'm done. Yay! Okay, so she is a lot taller than the Team Skull Grunt that I made in a previous video. But considering the fact that the grunts mostly consist of very young people, and Plumeria is most likely an adult, I think this is an okay height difference. And as for her shoes, and I'm pretty sure most people are wondering at this point, but I don't have any shoes that really fit this doll, and I don't really want to sculpt anything around her feet. I did this for her because she didn't have any feet, that was how the doll was made. So yeah, if I find some shoes that are good for her, I think I'll give them to her, but until then she's gonna have to stay barefoot. Yeah, I know this is not my best custom ever, but it was a lot of fun, especially her hair. It was something new that I've never tried before. That was a lot of fun. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!